Do subscribe to Ekeeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Hello friends. In the last lecture, we have studied the heat of reaction. And what is heat of reaction? We have got a formula there. We have made a formula of that also, how to calculate the numerical of that. And now based on that theory, we are going to calculate what would be the standard enthalpy of a particular reaction if particular data are being given to us. So let us do it. So this is the reaction that they have provided to us, and in that we have to calculate what would be the standard enthalpy of a particular for a formation of a particular product. So what they have said is, we have to calculate the standard enthalpy of formation of C2H6 from the following data. And they have mentioned the reactions also, that is 2 times of 2 moles of C2H6 plus 7 moles of oxygen molecule, that would have given us 4 molecules of CO2 plus 6 moles of H2O. And the overall heat of reaction is also been given to us, or that is minus 3119 kilojoules. And that of the heat of formation of carbon dioxide is also been given to us, that is minus 393.5 kilojoule per mole, while that of the heat of formation of H2O is also been given as, that is minus 285.8 kilojoule per mole. So in this case, what we have to do is, we have to calculate what will be the heat of formation of C2H6. So let us see that how can we solve this thing. So before solving this thing, we should know that what should be the heat of reaction, enthalpy change for the reaction. We know that the formula is very much simple, that is the delta H naught, that is for the overall reaction, it will be nothing but the summation of the delta H of the product minus the summation of the delta H, this is formation basically, so delta H naught formation of the reactants. So this is what we know, but the heat of formation of the product, that is, we have to write the what are the products and what are the heat formation that have been provided to us. So in that case, what we could write it as, now we are going to sum up all those products heat of formation. So in that case, we know that the products are basically 4 times of carbon dioxide, while that of 6 times of H2O. So we could write in this format as 4 into delta H formation of basically the first product, it was what we have got is for carbon dioxide. So this is the first thing that we are, so I am making it in this format so that we should not get confused between the signs, that is for plus sign for multiplication. So it would be very hectic for us to calculate this thing. So now plus the other product that we have, the other product that we have is basically 6 moles of H2O. So I would write in this way, that is 6 times of the heat of formation of water that has been provided to us, that is for H2O. So this is basically the one which we have sum up for the products. And again, we'll minus it with the heat of reaction of reactants that we have. So for reactant, what we have is 2 times of that is delta H heat of formation that we have to calculate for this C2H6 or yes, correct. And what I'm doing is I'll capture this, and again the other product that we have is 7 times that of the that we have to calculate, that is for oxygen molecule. So in this case, what we have datas, we have datas for the overall reaction, that is for the delta H of the reaction, which is nothing but minus 3119 kilojoule, as well as we have the information of the carbon dioxide, we have information about the heat of formation of water, as well as we have to calculate the heat of formation of C2H6. And in this case, what we don't have is, we don't have the heat of formation of oxygen. So if heat of formation oxygen is not being given, and we have to calculate or we have to estimate the answer of another data, so what we are going to do is, we since C2H6, the heat of formation of C2H6 is to be calculated, so this we will consider, but this value is not we have. So they have not provided the data of this thing. So what we are going to do is we are going to take the value of this thing as zero. So it would be very much easy for us to calculate this thing. So what I'm going to do rapidly is that I am going to substitute the values in this thing. So it would be giving me the value as, so -3119 kilojoule, which is equals to basically 4 into the delta H of carbon dioxide or the heat of formation of carbon dioxide, which is being nothing but -393.5. So this is for only the first product. So for the second product, what we have 6 into that is heat of formation of water, that is being given as -285.8 kilojoule per mole. Overall, what we have is basically 2 times of, this is what we have to calculate, the heat of formation of C2H6, and 7 times of, since oxygen value is not been given, so we'll take it as 0. So let us calculate and let us see what is the answer that we could get. So for that instance, we have 3119 in our consideration, and we'll multiply this thing by 4. So let us see what we get. So we have got this value as -1574 plus we are going to do this one, which is found to be, that is -1714.8. While that off, this is the thing that we have to calculate, that is 2 into delta H naught formation of C2H6. Well, this value would be 0. So I'll sum up this thing. So let us see what is the thing that we would get. So this is 3119, which is equals to -3291.8, and overall minus it is for 2 into delta H naught F for C2H6. So let us do it once again, the calculations, and for that we could get, so we have got the value as this thing as 172.8, and the value of this thing, that is, it would be remain as -2 into delta H naught F of C2H6. So if we calculate this thing by dividing this value by 2, then let us see what is the answer we could get. So therefore, delta H naught F for C2H6 is what we have got it as -172.8 divided by 2. So what we have got it as, we have got -86.4 kilojoule per mole. So this is basically the heat of formation of C2H6. Basically, the thing that we have got, that is the standard heat of formation of C2H6, that we have got as -86.4. So this is how we calculate. So thank you friends for watching this video. I hope we have understood that how to do this kind of numerical. We have got in a very deep detail, and thank you for watching this video. Share this video with your friends, and yes, don't forget to subscribe to Ekeeda channel. Thank you so much.